Okay, but don't the economic benefits, someone might argue, that don't the economic benefits of being friends or having better ties with China, don't they override all these arguments?
The mineral resources, mineral and fish resources, in the South China Sea are huge. They are going to be enjoyed by generations after us. I think the economic benefits is such a tiny fraction of what these benefits will provide for our people for generations to come. To be able to reserve this for them would mean that we have to defend our position in terms of exclusive rights. That's exclusively ours.
Okay. All right. We're going to take a quick break. Headstart. We'll be right back. Please stay with us.
Monday to Friday, 7 p.m. here on ANC.
The biggest news, the most compelling stories, and issues that matter to you. Top Story, weekdays and weekends, 5 p.m. here on ANC.
With us on Hot Copy, Foreign Affairs Secretary Albert Del Rosario and former Ombudsman Conchita Carpio-Morales. Do you both feel that you are in an unpopular fight or in a fight or a battle where you are both on your own? Well, together, but you know what I mean.
Well, if the support of the public is any indication, we don't feel that we are in an unpopular fight. On the contrary, they are supporting us. And in fact, the petition, which was initiated by Nazarlina Lim, was still in that stage at the time. But after the secretary and I was denied entry to Hong Kong, it zoomed to a greater number that it's now approximating 75 petitioners, signatories.
Okay. But do Filipinos really care? Let's start from that, Ambassador. Do they care about the West Philippine Sea issue? I mean, do you have numbers, polls,
yes,
studies
yes.
to show they care? Because even after all that China's done, where Malacanang stands, the pronouncements of the president, you have him at an amazing 80%+, which then would translate Malacanang might be thinking we're on the right track.
I'm glad you brought that up, Karen. I think we all know that the president enjoys an 80+ rating, that he's very popular, and compared to in the same survey. Where are people happy about the way we're asserting our sovereignty in terms of this tribunal outcome? 9 out of 10 Filipinos would like the government to assert its sovereignty.
Uh-oh. So what you're saying is while Filipinos do support the president overwhelmingly, they are making a separate stand on how we are dealing with China. It's not one and the same.
No, yes.
Okay.
Yes, that's right. In fact, if you go by percentages in rating, there are more who support the Philippine, the stand of those who are minded on our West Philippine Sea than the stand of the president. Okay.
Is there possibly something that you're not seeing? I'm just thinking, is the president, is there some strategy behind all this where the president sees a victory for the Philippines by going this way? Have you thought of that too? I'm curious. Like, he's a smart guy, you guys know that. So you're thinking, is there something we're not seeing that in the end we win in all this?
I think he is more concerned with the economic benefits that he expects to derive by being friendly and by being soft on China.
Okay. That's all. That, in other words, it's the economic benefits. Yeah.
If there is any other benefit that the president aims to achieve, we don't know.
Okay. Ambassador, is there something else, a strategy of some kind that you may not be seeing, that there's a victory with the president's moves after all this?
I think that I'm not sure what the answer is to that question, but I'd like to inject the idea that we are promoting the rule of law, that we are in fact promoting the idea of establishing a rules of order for the country.
Okay. Why are you both still in this battle? That's, I guess, as we close the show, what drives to go on?
We take cudgels for our poor fishermen. You recall that the communication we filed was short of 2 days before the withdrawal by the president of his membership in the ICC took effect, if it will turn out to be valid. We saw that there seemed to be no action on the part of the government to take the cudgels for them. And we saw that there has been an injustice, there has been abuse. So the ambassador, initially, he was alone, thought of filing the communication to demand accountability. Yeah. And of course, they, after some conferences, were able to convince me that indeed it was a worthy cause.
Okay.
And that prompted us to finally submit the communication.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. In the president's speech last night to close, he called Senior Justice Antonio Carpio stupid. He's mentioned your name as misusing your passport. It's almost like, I mean, you both took this case to the International Tribunal. It's like you're the enemy. It's not China, so to speak.
Yeah.
Is this the message that you'd want to send Malacanang?
Yeah.
It's almost like you and Senior Associate Justice Carpio, I mean, we're all Filipinos, and yet the battle seems to be within the country.
Yes, I think that, and we hope that the...
What would you want to say to President Duterte, if you can?
I would like to say to him that we're here not to oppose his policies, but we're here to encourage him to do what is right for our people, that we're here to remind him that our people should have primacy over China.
Well, let me comment on the president's calling Justice Carpio stupid. At about 1:30 in the morning, Panelo came up with a strained rationalization of what the president said. He says that the president did mean to say that Justice Carpio was wrong in declaring that allowing China to use our EEZ is unconstitutional. He merely said that China would not like to fish in our EEZ. You know, it's a strained interpretation. So the president, or the office of the president, backtracked. In other words, it was practically withdrawing the comment on Justice Carpio that he is stupid, because he is not.
Oh, okay, but then, you know, Justice Carpio said, "I won't dignify it with a comment."
Precisely.
See? Okay. Yeah. But what's the implication of, I mean, we've clearly resorted to these words of bobo, stupid, with public officials and someone like Senior Associate Justice Carpio. I mean, in a bigger spectrum, where have we gone?
Well, he knew that he would be proven right.
Okay.
He did not dignify it.
On that note, I want to thank you so much, former Ombudsman Conchita Carpio-Morales, always. Former ambassador, and of course, the title you still hold, Ambassador Del Rosario, thank you so much for coming to Head Start.